Hello and welcome to Tokes Go Models. I'm Steve. You know that already. So today I thought I would do a what's in the box of the Takom HMS hood gun turret B. Got this sort of at Telford. Got it from Jadlam and they did me a very good deal on it. They didn't have it on stand, but they ordered it and sent it to me. Turned around pretty quick, so very pleased with that because I didn't actually have it in stock at their store, but he was restocking it and I got it just over a week after Telford, so really pleased with that. Now the hood has significant in my family due to the fact that my grandfather served on HMS Hood, not when she was sunk in the Second World War, but before that, and then he transferred to another ship before that fatal incident. So yeah, this is why I want to build this. I've got the 1350 hood there to build. I'm not quite sure when I'm going to build that because I need to get the photo etch etc. for that, and I want to do it some justice, but I thought I'd build this thanks to Lewis. he pointed me out on this one, so yeah, looking forward to building this. It's just a gun turret on its own on a plinth, I think will look very nice indeed. So without further ado, let's go down, open the box up and see what's inside. So here we are, HMS Hood Mark 1 15 inch 42 gun turret B by Takom, 1/72 scale. Yeah, let's look in the box. I don't know if you want kit numbers. 5020. Part count. No idea. But it's a detailed static display, plastic model, two types of markings, base included. So. Here we go. So, quite full of plastic. Well, not full plastic, but it's a big kit. So, I shall move this to one side. And we shall start to take a look. So, we have the actual turret housing itself. And, yeah, that's nice. Excuse me, that's a nice detail there. You got a lot of all the bolts and stuff for it. It's a good size. So the length of the actual turret bit itself is 6.5 inches, and it is 5.5 inches wide. So yeah, a bit clean up here and there. And this comes in two parts, so yeah, that is looking pretty good. So we'll put that back to that side. And we will take these pieces out. Again, sorry for the plastic rustling, but you know, hey ho. So these are the two side walls of the turret. Yeah, it's clearly got some attachment points there for bits to go on the side. And then just hollow inside, and then yeah, so I'm probably completely wrong because that's probably going to be the bottom, so yeah, and that's going to be the bottom as well, so there's a bit of a div there, wouldn't it be? Score here. So yep, that's that bit. Let's just put that there and that there. So our next piece is the actual base. That it sits on, and no, I will actually put that to one side. So we can see we've got a nice plinth flip to go on, and then we've got some deck detail. If I just show the light, yeah, you've got some deck detail there, and I presume that that is where that will go in. I presume there's going to be one for one Pacific side, yes, because there's that length fits in that particular slot. So yeah, so that slits in that side, and then obviously that one will go in that side because this slot here is longer than that one, so it corresponds to that tab on there. So just put that to one side, and we've got some other holes here where I'm sure other pieces will sit. Now what I'm thinking is I will do the deck like a deck tan color, perhaps, maybe, or a yellowy color, I'm not quite sure, not like yellow, but you know what I'm saying. And then what I might do here is do like it's a wood brown sort of color, so it's like a proper wooden plinth that it sits on, and then that will sit nicely. So we just put that to one side. Our next actual sprues here we have, so these are the actual gun shrouds. Now looks like we've got two lots, so you can obviously looks like we can have the gun in different positions, so as in like or you know, as in straight or up, perhaps we shall see. And then we got bits and pieces which sit on the top, yep, and some small details, fine details, some grab handles. This is sprue D. Yeah, so we'll put that there. Our next sprue in the next bag. And this is sprue C. So we've got more detail bits. I think this bit sits on here somewhere on top. Yep, and some, not sure where these bits actually go, but we can look at that when we look at the instructions. But detail looks very good. A lot of rivet bolt heads detail there, and again there. Again there as well, yeah, so quite good detail with bolt heads etc, and in there as well, very much so. But where the actual detail is, doesn't look like to be any like issues with plastic. So yeah, it's very nice. Then we've got a small bag. And we have two sprues in this bag. These are repeated, and these are sprues B. So we put that one to there because obviously it's just a repeat of this one. So here we got some little grab handles. No idea what these other pieces are. I'm sure we'll find out. And then we got like tubes. Not so much tubes because they're not hollow, but yep. And like I say, we've got two of those. There's a sprue bead. So again, I have no idea what these parts are, but The detail on there is very nice, and I presume that's the side that you will see. So yep. And then our last screw again is doubled up. Get this one out of the bag if it wants to come out. Put that to one side. So as I said, this is doubled up, so we will put that one there. And we have our barrels. Yep. Look quite smooth. Flared at the end. Yeah, smooth. So I presume that once we put these together, there might be some sort of seam line, so we might have to do some work on that. Some sort of fencing, and I believe these pieces go around the side of the base. So yeah, quite nice. So quite a simple part count. Then we have our destructions. So let's open up. So we got your normal beware sort of stuff. Got a sprue call out, parts call out, and we're starting straight off with the base and the two side walls. Yeah, so what I think I will do is I'll probably paint this before going, I'll probably paint this separate, do this all separate, paint it and then assemble it. Instructions seem quite easy enough to follow. So we're doing all our detailing around the actual base of the turret. Make one, make two, make two, make two. We've got some detail inside. Not sure why we've got detail inside, but there must be a reason. Then some more detailed parts being put together. Certain instructions, they don't actually tell you what the pieces are, but hey ho. So B3, we've got like a plus thing in there, not quite sure what that is, but then we've got a ladder going in, then we've got these pieces housing being added on, the base being added to the turret. So now this is the piece that I was showing to go around, goes on top, I believe. So it's just showing you some bits and pieces that you need to put in. Oh, it goes on a flat plate first of all, by the looks of it. What was that place we tried to put on there? Dealing with these, putting these together, make two, because then you want to put two on the base. Then that goes on. Then in here we've got, it's like railings to go around it. So that's all good. And okay, I think I missed a pose there. Yep, I have. Then we're making these. Oh, these are the what those tube things are for. Must be some sort of launchers, I'm not sure. Building up the housing for this, and that then sits on top of the turret. On top of that, then we're building our barrel. Got an end cap which goes in there. Okay, so they look exactly the same. By looking orientation of that, you have the gun level, or That looks like the gun is raised, or the actual barrels are raised. So, yeah, I suppose you could have one level, one down. I don't know. That's how it shows it in the picture, isn't it, on the artwork. And then it's just a matter of assembling it all together. So yeah, what I think I would do is I would paint this first of all, paint this all separate, then put it all together, and then you can do that. And then this is your color call out, was not actually a color call out, because it doesn't actually say what the colors are, and I don't remember seeing an actual call out for the actual colors. Nope. So it says they're mid colors, but it doesn't say what ones to use, but I'm sure you use your own discretion. So this is where it's all gray and it has this piece on top. So you see how they've done there with the decking. I might try and do something similar, but then where they've done the grey around there, I think I will do that in brown. So trying to get like a, not necessarily a wooden effect, but a wood colour. And then you have a different colour scheme here, and a slightly different model. So these ones, you've got the red, white and blue stripes across the top, and there's no like rocket thing on top there either. But other than that, it's exactly the same. But like it, as I say once again, color info and profiles by MIG, but there is no call out. There's nothing on the back, is there? No. There's no decals in it because it didn't have any. It hasn't got any. There's no need for decals. So yeah, it's strange. It doesn't. It just tells you it's by MIG, but it doesn't actually tell you what the colors are. Hey ho. And at the front of the page, you've got some information about the actual gun itself, the turret, should I say, gun turret B. The Admiral class battlecruiser HMS Hood featured a main battery made up of 8 BL 15 inch Mark 1 cannons, mounted in twin gun turrets with hydraulic propulsion. From bow to stern, the turrets were assigned in letters A, B, X, and Y. The main guns of the Hood were a 15-inch calibre and were considered to be the greatest naval cannons ever mounted on a British battleship. All crew members, as well as every system on board HMS Hood, was there to service the firing of these guns with turret face armour that was 15 inches thick. They were the area of HMS Hood that was most heavily protected. Each of the turrets were perched atop a barbettes, which were covered in armor up to 12 inches thick to safeguard the supply line for shells. Each gun turret had a local control rangefinder mounted near the rear and could fire up to 4 rounds a minute. Wow, impressive, especially 4 rounds a minute when there's only actually 2 barrels. Very good indeed. And there's just a black and white profile picture. Very impressive. So I should look forward to building this. Let's go back up. Well, I'm pretty impressed with that. That's not too many, not a high part count, but some very good detail. It's a bit shame that in instructions they don't tell you what actual different parts are, because I have no idea what some of those parts are. Obviously we know the barrels and we know the actual gun turret itself, and then the wooden deck, but there's some bits I have no idea, so I might have to try and do a little bit of research into that and see what I can find out. And strange that there's no color call out at all. Do find that a little bit strange.
Oh, excuse me.
Oh, yawning on camera again all the time. But yeah, I thought that was a bit strange, no color call out, but it's gray, isn't it? But there's always gonna say, what is all sorts of different grays, you know, 50 shades of gray. Yeah, we know. but I shall look into seeing what I can get for that one. I might go with the Outlaw paints again, so I should speak to James and say, what you got, please? That's James at Sprue Box, obviously, because they're doing the Outlaw paints. I am liking those paints, they are very nice. So yeah, that's about it. Just like to say thanks for watching. Thanks to all my subscribers, that's very good. Any new subscribers just recently joined, thank you very much as well. If you've liked what you've seen, give the old Imperial thumbs up, that'd be great. And if you're not a subscriber, please subscribe, that'd be great. Don't forget, we've got the Facebook group, Tactical Models, the same. Come and give us a join. And yeah, so I shall see you in the next video. In the meantime, stay safe, take care, and keep on modeling. Bye.